Now, class 12, today I am going to tell you solution of linear simultaneous equation by matrix method. So, how we will do this one? Now, suppose that you have three equations, a11x plus a12y plus a13z equals to k1, a21x plus a22y plus a23z equals to k2, then a31x plus a32y plus a33z equals to k3. Okay, if you have this type of thing, then how you will find the solution of the linear simultaneous equation using matrix method. So now, what is matrix method? First of all, for this one, always we take this one as an equation 1. Now, you will ask what is A, what is X and what is O. A is coefficient of this equation, 3 equation. A is coefficient of this 3 equation. So, how many coefficients we have? A11, A21, A31, here A12, A22, A32. Then A13, A23, A33. So always A represent coefficient of given equation. Okay. Now X, we will take X as X, Y, Z. Okay. We will always take X as X, Y, Z. And B value would be constant of the given equations. So constant are k1, k2, k3 means k1, k2, k3 means A is coefficient, X represent x, y, z, you have to write because here we have x, y, z, x, y, z, x, y, z in each quotient, and B is constant. Okay, now after that, if you will see this one from equation 1, what you can say that if you are finding X, so if A will go that side, it will become A inverse equal X equals to A inverse B. Okay, and you know what is the formula for A inverse? A inverse formula is adjugate A dot B by determinant A. Means I am just writing A inverse formula. A inverse formula is adjugate A by determinant A dot B. Okay. Now, complete up to here. Now, class 12, I have written 3 conditions for this linear simultaneous equation. If determinant A does not equal to 0, then from 2 means from equation 2, equations have unique solution and consistent. It means that we have to find each and every question. If they will ask whether the given equation are consistent or non-consistent or unique or no solution, this type of question will ask at that time. Each and every time, first you will find determinant A. Okay, determinant A you will find. Okay, if it is coming determinant A equals to 0, if A determinant A does not equals to 0. If determinant A does not equals to 0, then what you will say? Unique solution and consistent. Okay. And in the second case, if determinant A equals to 0, means determinant A value will be 0, and adjoint A dot B, dot B means multiplication B. You will find adjoint A and B. This one is also, it is does not equals to 0, means determinant will be 0, but when you multiply adjoint A and B, you are not getting 0. At that time, what you write? Then from 2 means equation 2, equation have no solution and inconsistent. Means if determinant is 0 but adjoint A dot B is not equal to 0, then equation have no solution and inconsistent. If both will be 0, means determinant A equals to 0 and adjoint A dot B equals to 0, then from 2 equation have infinite solution, then there is no consistency for third one. Okay, so please copy this one. Now class 12, come to short answer question number 21. using matrix method show that the equation 6x minus 4y plus 1 equals to 0 and 9x minus 6y equals to 2 are inconsistent. So what is the condition for inconsistent? Condition is that at determinant A should be 0 and adjoint A dot B should not equals to 0. If this condition will satisfy, then you can see this one is inconsistent. Okay, so we have to find determinant A, adjoint A, and we have to multiply adjoint A with B to find whether A 0 is coming or not. Okay, so I am starting. Short answer, question number 2-1. Question is 6A minus 4Y plus 1 equals to 0. Then you have 9X minus 6Y equals to 2. Now, what you will do first, you will write AX equals to B. This one is compulsory, you have to write. From here, we will find X equals to A inverse B, okay? And in case of A inverse, what you will write? Adjoint A by determinant A and B as it is, okay? So this is 2 and B, okay? Now see this one. In this one, what you can see? 2 plus 1, I am taking that side, minus 1. And this one as it is, I am writing. Now we will find first x value, a value. So what will be the a value? A always coefficient. A will take only the coefficient thing. So 6 and minus 4 coefficient, 6 minus 4, and here 9 and minus 6. 9 and minus 6. Okay, I am writing. Then x, I told you that you have to take x, y. Why I am not taking z? Because we have only two variables, x and y, there is no z present. Okay, and b always we will take constant terms. So constant terms are minus 1 and 2. Minus 1 and 2. Okay, now we have to find determinant A first. Okay, determinant A. It means we will write 6 minus 4, 9 minus 6. Okay, now it is very easy because it is 2 into 2, 2 by 2 matrix. So we are learning that one into determinant. So we will do what? Cross multiplication, diagonal multiplication. 6 into minus 36, 6 into minus 6, minus 36. Then minus sign you have to put. 9 into minus 4, minus 36. So minus 36, minus minus plus 36. You are getting determinant A equals to 0. Okay, you are getting determinant A equals to 0. It means your first condition is fulfilled. Okay, for inconsistent, first condition is that determinant A should be 0. So you are getting 0. Up to here you all have understood, I think. Now for next part, we have to find adjoint A and we have to multiply that adjoint A with B. Okay, complete this one. I have to work this part. Now for finding adjoint A, what you will do? Adjoint A is very easy for this. What you will do? You will change their places. So minus 6 will come up and 6 will go down. And here you will change the sign. Okay. So minus will become plus 4 and plus 9 will become minus 9. So this is adjoint A. Okay. Now you have to multiply with adjoint A with B. Okay. So okay, I am doing minus 6, 4, minus 9, 6. And B is what? Minus 1 and 2. Okay, now multiply this one, this row with this column. So minus 6 into minus 1 plus 6, 4 into 2 plus 8. Okay, minus 9 into 1, 9, 6 into 2, 12. See, you are getting what? 14 and 18. So it is not equals to 0. Means adjoint A into B is not equals to 0. And determinant A equals to 0, therefore it shows that there is no solution and the system is inconsistent. So you will write, how you will write? Since determinant A equals to 0 and adjoint A dot B does not equals to 0, so it is Now class 12, see short answer question number 4-1. Three equations are given to you and they are asking that in each of the following cases show using matrix method that the given system of linear equation has infinite number of solution. What is the condition for infinite number of solution? Condition third, condition number 3 is that determinant A equals to 0 as well as adjoint A dot B equals to 0. If both will come, then you can say it has this equation, system of equations have infinite number of solution. Okay, so first I have written 3 equations given. Okay, then I am writing Ax equals to B, x equals to A inverse B equals to adjoint A. In place of adjoint A inverse, I am writing adjoint A by determinant A dot B. Okay, now A is nothing but coefficient of the given equation. So coefficient is here, so nothing means 1, then 3, 5, 3, 5, then 2, 4, 6, 2, 4, 6, then 3, 5, 7, 3, 5, 7. Now x you will take x, y, z. Why? Because in the given equations there are 3 variables x, y, z, that is why I am writing x, y, z. And b means constant term 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Now first we have to find the determinant of A. Okay, determinant of A. First I am writing determinant of A. I am converting this matrix to determinant. It will come 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, 5, then 5, 6, 7. Okay. Now how you will find when it is 3 by 3 matrix determinant? You will write 1. Then you will not see this row and this column. So if you will not see this row and this column, left one will be multiplied diagonally. Means 4 7s are 28 minus 6 5s are 30. Then with this one you have minus, will give minus 2. Okay, to 2 you will write this column, you will not see now. You will not see this column and this row. If you are not seeing this row and this column, what is left? 3 5 6 7 again cross multiplication. 3 into 7, 21. 5 into 5, 25. Okay, now again you will write plus 3 here. Now again cross multiplication, you will not see this column and this row. Now multiplication in between this 2, 3, 6 are 18, minus 4, 5 are 20. Okay, now how much will you get? Minus 2 here. Now minus 25 minus 21, 4, minus 4, minus 4 into 2, plus 8. Okay, then plus 3. Plus 18 minus 20 minus 2 into 3 minus 6. Now see minus 2 minus 6 minus 8 plus 8, you are getting determinant 0. So first condition is fulfilled. Now we have to go to second condition, which is adjoint A dot B. First we have to find adjoint A. Okay, please copy up to here. Now adjoint A, how will you find when there is 3 cross 3 matrix? Adjoint A, you have done cofactor of elements. Now what you will do? See, I am finding cofactor of elements this. So I will not see this and this. What is that? 4, 5, 6, 7. So I am writing 4, 5, 6, 7. Then after that, I will give minus sign. Why minus sign? Because we know here plus sign. When I am finding cofactor, I did all this in previous class. I am not repeating again, but I am just telling you how to do. Okay, one, I will see, I will just cover this row and this column. 4, 5, 6, 7 left, I am writing 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, then here we have plus sign, here we have minus sign. So I have to put minus sign. Now when I am coming in this one, I will not see this row and this column. What is left? 3, 5, 6, 7. So I will write 3, 5, 6, 7. Okay. Now again, three we have plus sign, so I am not writing any sign now. I will not see this row, this column. What is left? 3, 4, 5, 6. 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Now come here. Here we have a minus sign. When we were finding cofactor, I told you that in the first row there is plus minus plus, then minus plus minus, then minus, then plus minus plus. Okay. So we have to put minus sign. I will not see this column, this row and this column. So what is left? 2, 3, 6, 7. 2, 3, 6, 7. Okay. Then again plus sign I have to put. If you are not putting plus sign, it's okay. because if there is no sign, it means plus sign. Now I will not see the fifth element. If I am not seeing this fifth element, it means I will not see this column and this row. What is that? 1, 3, 5, 7. Now you have to put again minus sign here. Now you will not see this element, means this row and this column. So what is there? 1, 2, 5, 6. 1, 2, 5, 6. Again you have to put plus sign here. If you are not putting, it's okay. Now when we are starting from here, I will not see this row and this column. It means 2, 3, 4, 5. 2, 3, 4, 5. Then again I have to put one minus sign. I will not see this column and this row. 1, 3, 3, 5. Okay, 1, 3, 3, 5. 1, 3, 3, 5. Now, when I am looking at for this one, I will not see this column and this row. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Up to here, you all are understanding. I think just I am finding the cofactor. Now cross multiplication. 4 into means diagonal multiplication. 4 into 7, 28. Minus 6 into 5, 30. Okay. Then minus sign I have to put. Okay. 3 into 7, 21. Minus 6 5 are 30. No sign. 3 6 are 18. 4 5 are 20. Okay. Then minus sign. 7 2 are 14. 6 3 are 18. 1 7 is 7. 5 3 are 15. Minus 1 6 are 6. 5 2 are 10. Okay. Now again 2 5 are 10. 4 3 are 12. Okay. Then minus I have to do. 1 5 are 5. 3 3 are 9. Okay. Then 1 4 is 4. 3 4 2 are 6. Okay. Now after this, how much I am getting? Minus 2 here. Here 30 minus 21, 9. This plus 9. Okay. Then minus 2 again. Then 18 minus 4. Minus minus plus 4. Okay. Because when no minus sign is there. Here minus 8. Then plus 4. Here minus 2. Here minus plus 4. Here 9 minus 5. 4 minus minus plus minus 2. So aggregate one I got this much. Okay. Okay, this one 3 6 5 are 37. This one will be 5. Make it 5. So this one will be 25 and it one will be 4. Okay. Maybe I have done some mistake. Okay, so please go through it once, you will understand. Complete up to here. Now class 12, you can see aggregate A dot B. So I have written aggregate A and B values 1, 2, 3. Now we have to multiply this one. So how we will multiply? There is a multiplication. Minus 2 into 1. Minus 2 means first row, and first column there is only one column. 4 into 2, 8. Minus 2 into 3. 6. Okay. Then 4 into 1, 4. Minus 8 into 2, minus 16. 4 into 2, 8. Now minus 2 into 1, minus 2. Then plus 8, then minus 6. Now you can see minus 2 minus 6 will give you minus 8, plus 8 will give you 0. Then again plus 4, 12 plus 12 will give you 16, then minus 16 will give you 0. Minus 2, minus 6, 8, minus 8, plus 8 will give you 0. So what you will write? 6, determinant A equals to 0 and aggregate A dot B equals to 0. Therefore, equations have infinite number of solution. Okay, copy this one. Class 12, your homework is short answer question number 2 to long answer question number 10, and it is same as example 10. If you will not understand, go through example 10, you will get how to do. And you have to submit your homework here. If you have any query, you will ask in this given item. Okay, thank you.